skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide. Well, nobody's interested in learning but the teacher. Segregation, determination, demonstration, integration, aggravation, humiliation, obligation to my nation.
Good morning and welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. This is our second week of interviews at the North American International Auto Show. My friends, when we think of the car companies, we don't think of the women that are actually running the car companies and designing our vehicles. This week, I'm going to show you the 2015 Canyon from both sides. First up, I have Helen Emsley, Executive Director, GMC Global Experience and Entertainment. Did I get it right?
No.
Okay. I get it wrong.
No problem.
Do your title for me.
It's Global Design for GMC and User Experience.
That's right. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry about that.
No, no problem.
Okay. You designed not only the interior of the Corvette, which we talked about with Ed Welburn last week, but you designed the interior of these larger trucks. Tell me about that. How does that happen?
Well,
and what vehicles did you design?
Okay, my team designed the interior for the Corvette, the new full-size trucks, the new SUVs, and the mid-size truck. They designed all the interiors for these. It was my team that did it. So it was kind of nice, especially today, to see that we just took the award for the Corvette and for the car, you know, the pickup truck.
That's two feathers in your hat.
Well, my team. It's my team.
How big is your team?
It's about 30 people in design, in the design studio that worked on these cars. And each, we had a team working on each vehicle. Yeah.
Okay, now is the design studio located in just Warren, Michigan, or where?
We have design studios all over the world. But the main one where we did these vehicles were in design, it was here in Warren. But when we started the Corvette, though, we actually, we talked to Ed, and we actually did a global search. So we asked all the studios around the world to design the next Corvette.
Really?
Yes.
When we talked to him last week, I told him about my C5, which I loved in 2000. Yeah. He said, this car is totally different, and it has seven speeds.
Yes.
That's
shocking.
Now, you did the interior of that car. Yeah. Tell me about the process of making the screen disappear into the car.
Okay. What happened was, when we designed the new design, we really liked the lines of the design, and we liked the lines of the IP. But we had that 8-inch screen, and everybody who drives a Corvette knows there's hardly anywhere for storage. And we had the opportunity behind the screen to put storage. But as in all the Cadillacs and our other vehicles, the screen goes up. But we did not want to destroy the beautiful lines of our IP on the Corvette. So we didn't know what to do. We didn't want it to go up. We needed the storage. It was kind of like a no-win.
Because in the Corvette, there is no storage.
There is no storage, and we know. And you need a place to put your sunglasses, your parking tickets, anything like that. You want to put your wallet as you're
your
driving.
Your speeding tickets?
Exactly.
Your speeding tickets.
Of course. You know, I'm a British member, so I've got to go lead foot. So, you know, you need all these things to put, you know, to put some storage. So anyway, we were in a, you know, we didn't know what to do. And one of the designers on my team, actually, one of the interior design manager, actually, said, hey, why don't we drop the screen? So we're like, we could do this. So we worked with engineering because, you know, we'd never done that before in any of our vehicles. We'd always gone up. So we worked, and they found a way that you can actually press the button and the screen goes down into the vehicle. You can get access to the storage, and then the screen comes back up.
That's amazing.
So, I know, it was the first. We were so pleased because we were so worried if we could do it.
You're the head of infotainment also.
Yes.
And some vehicles you get in that have these entertainment systems, you need a PhD to operate.
I know.
How did you simplify it?
Well, we're still not fully there. We still got a lot of work to do on the infotainment. That's going to be one of my goals this year, because even I struggle. A lot of the times, it's very hard to understand. It's okay for my child. I've got an 11-year-old. He can get in my car and he knows it straight away. He knows what to do. But for a lot of us, it's very difficult. So we're there, but we still need to work further on how we simplify it and how you can easily read it as well. Because we don't want people taking their eyes off the road because they can't see it or they're trying to find what they need to do. So that's something that we've got to actually improve.
Okay. When we come back, you've been working for GM for 25 years.
Yes, this year.
I want to talk about the transitions that you've seen.
Okay.
All right?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back to Detroit Wants to Know with Detroit Wants to Know. Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. I'm with Helen Emsley. Miss Emsley?
Yes.
Executive Director, GMC, Global Design and User Experience.
Yes.
I told you I'd get
yes,
it right.
Yes, you did.
You've been with GMC. It took you a long time to get that title. You've been there 25 years. How did you get from England to the United States?
Okay. I studied in England. I grew up in England. Uh-huh. But I actually started my first job at General Motors in Germany. I went to work for GME, which then was renamed Opel. So I went to the design studio in Germany. And I actually then worked in color and trim. So I used to work and do all the interior materials and exterior paints for our vehicles over in Europe. And then after 9 years, the then head of design, Wayne Cherry, asked me to come here to America to head up the color and trim studio here in Detroit.
25 years ago.
Yes.
There weren't that many women around GMC.
No.
Tell me about that.
No, and I worked over in Germany as well. So at GME, there were very few women in any high positions. Mm-hmm. In fact, most of the women in design then were either in the color and trim studio where I were, or they were the admins.
What was it like during the years of bankruptcy for GM when they were about to go under? How did you all just keep going?
Do you know what? You just have a positive attitude. Mm-hmm. And it's great working in design because we already are. We're very positive. Mm-hmm. Me, my personality, you know what, we don't take defeat, we keep going, kept sketching, kept coming up with new ideas. We knew eventually the programs would start again, things would be better. We just kept going, just keep a good, positive attitude.
Tell us about the difference in the quality of life between Germany and the United States, because that was your intermediary stop.
Yes.
So what's the difference?
I think here in America, people don't realize, here in America, if you want to be something, you can be it. There's no discrimination, you know, people, you know, well, you know what I mean, I know. But what I mean is, if you set your heart on being something, like Steve Jobs, all these people, if you say, I'm going to start my own company, I'm going to be a doctor, I'm going to go to college to do that, you can. Over in Germany, it's a lot more class, you know, oriented. People don't expect you to do what you want to do. I just think there's more freedom here.
What would you tell the children of Detroit to help them excel?
Do you know what? If you have a dream and you want to do something, don't let anybody ever tell you you can't do it. That's the biggest thing I would tell any kid growing up now. When I was growing up in England, I come from a mining village in England.
A mining village?
A mining village. And
really?
Most of the people that I grew up with, they still live in that village.
Uh-huh.
And I knew I wanted to be a designer. So my parents, great, they were great, they supported me. I went to college. I slept on somebody's couch to get through my master's degree. If you want to be something, you can be it. Don't let anybody pull you back. You set a goal and you go for it.
That's amazing. What do your friends say when you come back home?
When I go back home, they're all very proud and they're very pleased. I just don't say a lot about it because not everybody has achieved or done the things. We talk about things from home, things that we have in common, the great places, great times. But they're all really pleased of what's happened. But you can be whatever you want to be.
What do you think about the change in Detroit over the last 5 years?
I think it's amazing. I really, really do. I think that the way, you know, like the rents end now, the way that everything's going, the opportunities for everybody, the schools. I mean, my child goes to school in this area.
In the metropolitan area, yes.
Yes, yes. So I have a son, he's American. He was born here and he's brought up here. So the opportunities are there.
The opportunities are there if you follow your dream.
Yes, and don't let anybody tell you you can't do it.
That's impressive. Okay. Anything else you want to add about this beautiful thing?
Come and have a look at it. It's a wonderful, wonderful truck. We just tell people, come and see our vehicles. We have
go
great
into the
vehicles.
Showroom
go
and see them.
Go and see them. Get inside and sit in one of them and see the great, rich materials that we put in these vehicles now.
It's a beautiful truck. It looks like it fits me better than that Corvette did last week.
Yes.
You know.
This is a great truck, but the Corvette's good too. The only problem is the Corvette, you go too fast, you get speeding tickets. Stick with this one.
You go too fast in this, you get speeding tickets.
Yeah, but they don't tend to look at you so much in this one. You know, they think you've got, you know, you're not that high, you know, that young kid with that fast car.
Well, when we come back, we're going to talk to Anita Burke.
Okay.
Who was one of the lead engineer on the 2015 Canyon.
Yes.
Thank you very much,
Miss Emsley. You're very, very welcome. Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it from Miss Emsley. Stick to your dream, and you can fit in a truck. Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. Now we're going to turn to the 2015 Canyon truck. We have the vehicle chief engineer, Anita Burke. Anita Burke, tell us about this fabulous vehicle.
It's a very exciting vehicle that we're bringing forth. We're really reinventing the midsize truck pickup segment. It's been a long abandoned, orphaned, neglected segment. Mm-hmm. We're bringing forth the GMC Canyon that comes with the demanding, capable characteristics of the GMC DNA. Not only looks and styled to give that professional grade of the GMC, but it's also going to deliver. It's going to have exceptional capability with over 6,700 pounds of towing capability, but it has the refinement.
Wait. That truck, it's not a huge truck.
It is
not. It's going to have 6,700 pounds?
Absolutely.
Okay, and four doors?
Four doors. We have two configurations, a crew cab model, as comes in two pickup boxes, a 5 foot and a 6 foot bed, mm-hmm. and then an extended cab body that has a 6 foot bed.
Okay. What's the mileage on this thing?
We're not releasing right now our fuel economy numbers on it, but stay tuned. It's engineered to be segment leading for fuel economy.
Now let's talk about segment leading, all right? You're obviously a female.
I am.
Were there any touches inside the vehicles that were done, the Canyon, that were done just for females?
We clearly look at every customer. When you look at the midsize truck vehicle, it is utilized by every member of the family. It's a lifestyle vehicle. The members of the midsize truck customer, they not only use it for work and functionality, they use it for everyday usage, especially commuting, which is key. We want to make sure that we have accessibility. Mm-hmm. So our entry egress of our doors is very good. We have exceptional storage throughout the vehicle. We have exceptional conductivity intelligence throughout the vehicle. We have the safety features. We have standard rear camera. Mm-hmm. We have optional lane departure warning and front collision alert safety features. All of those are considering that in mind.
Let's talk about connectivity. Mm-hmm. Do you need to be a rocket scientist to operate the connectivity in this vehicle?
No, it's very intuitive, very obvious, and very clear for the customer. Everything's accessible from the seating positions to make sure it's easy and intuitive for the customer to use.
Okay, so when I want to go in there and I plug in my iPod, all right, it's simple, right?
Right. You have a nice screen in your center stack that mm-hmm. has nice large buttons that you hit, and it'll be all clear menu choices, large buttons, easy access.
Okay, because I rented a car from one of your competitors in California, and I was confused.
Well, you'll have to talk to them. There will be no confusion in our vehicles.
Okay. What else can you tell me about it? What's the ground clearance?
The ground clearance is obviously it's a truck. We have an air dam on the front of it, but we want to make sure we still clear the eight inch curb. So it's clear for that. It's still a truck. That air dam is removable by the customer if they choose to, if they really want to do some aggressive off-roading. We have the appropriate amount of shielding underneath it, and it could do whatever you need it to do as a truck.
Okay. Last week, I asked Ed Welburn about security of the truck. We're obviously here in Detroit. This Detroit wants to know. If people buy your truck, is it easy to steal?
You know, we have the steering lock systems on the truck, the accessibility of the truck. You know, I think it's engineered to ensure the right security of our mm-hmm. our customers both on the road and while it's parked.
And it has that OnStar thing.
Absolutely. OnStar is absolutely an absolute feature for our customer in any event of what they need, and hook them up for any connection they need.
Well, Detroit's a different kind of place.
It is.
And the reason why I have to ask you the theft question is because autos and trucks get stolen. They like to go in and mess with the center consoles and all that stuff. Okay. You've been an engineer at GM for how long?
Since 1991.
Since 1991.
Has it been
23 years.
And now you have the head of GM is actually a female.
Mary Barra, yes.
Mary
Very exciting Barra. Times.
That's an amazing thing.
It is.
When we come back, I want you to tell us how a little girl grows up to be Anita Burke. It'd
be my pleasure.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with Detroit Wants to Know. Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. I'm here with Anita Burke at the North American International Auto Show. She is the lead engineer. Vehicle chief engineer on the 2015 Canyon. Ms. Burke, you've taken us through the truck. You've taken us through a little bit of your history at GM. Tell us, how do young ladies grow up to be an Anita Burke?
Well, first and foremost, you got to follow your passion. You got to find what you love. My family, my parents, they are immigrants from Ireland who came into this country with not a high level of education, and they really stress the importance of getting a fundamental education. Mm-hmm. What I learned was my passion was math and science, mm-hmm. and that really triggered something for me as a joy. and I found it exciting. Many kids these days aren't finding the excitement of it, and it's our job to really show them what they can do with it. A lot of kids think it's just math and science and number crunching, and it's when will I ever use it? Well, if you look around, we use math in everything we do, and the trucks that we create, the cars that we create here at General Motors, use that fundamental math and science. And getting kids excited about that, that was my passion, and that, you know, grew through my high school years and drove me right into education.
Now, where you got your master's degree from
the University of Michigan.
University of Michigan.
While I was working for General Motors. Prior to that, I did my undergrad also in mechanical engineering.
Really? Mm-hmm. Now, when you started at General Motors, what did you start off as?
I was a wheel engineer, so I was designing wheels. Component level testing of our wheels that are on our cars and trucks, making sure they pass all validation testing.
And so you worked your way all the way up?
I did. I had various assignments throughout the company, both in component. I moved into performance. I did noise and vibration, ride and handling, did a vehicle performance management position where I developed integrated the whole systems, all the systems together into a vehicle that's going to perform well. I spent time on the design side, doing a component design, both in body and structure enclosures. I had a great opportunity to spend two international assignments, one in our engineering center in Toluca, Mexico, and another in Sao Paulo, Brazil.
Wow, that's impressive.
So lots of opportunity when you find your passion.
What would you say to parents? How do they raise an Anita Burke?
I think it is encouraging your children to be open-minded and look for a broad range of things that are available. And then once they find that passion, encourage it, grow it, water it, and really encourage it. Because with that encouragement, they're going to shine. And we want people doing what jobs that they really enjoy, because that's where they're going to excel.
So you'd say encouragement.
Yes.
Okay. Well, I'm going to tell you, I'm impressed with the truck. Some of the trucks are too big for me. Actually, I like a smaller truck. The big trucks are scary. But I'm more impressed with you, okay? You worked your way up through the company. Mm-hmm. You've got your master's in engineering during your tenure at the company.
Correct.
What's next?
Well, I want to launch this truck, get it to the dealerships here in the fall of 2014, and continue developing exceptional trucks for this company. So I love what I do, and I love delivering our products, and I'm open to what this company needs from me.
Do you want to give us a hint as to what comes after 2015?
It's always going to be better. Obviously, in 2016, obviously for this truck, the Colorado Canyon's going to come in with a diesel engine.
A diesel engine.
So, yep. Okay. So you're going to see our 2.8 liter diesel Duramax coming in the next model year after this.
Wow, that's impressive.
It's got a great lineup for you.
All right. Is there anything you want to leave us with?
Oh, just again, it's a pleasure talking with you, and the Colorado Canyon's going to be an exceptional vehicle that I think every customer is going to enjoy.
Okay.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in to Detroit Wants to Know. Remember, the daughters can do it too. This is your chance. Stay motivated. Have a great week. And catch us at SteveHoodUSA.com. People moving out, people moving in. Why? Because of the color of the skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide. Well, nobody's interested in learning, but the teacher.